to the developments involving the new Vikings Stadium. Today, the Minnesota Sports Facilities Commission is considering several proposals related to the new stadium. A meeting just wrapped up, and our Kate Renner is live right now to break it down for us. Kate?
Well, the American Indian movement took front and center stage today, asking the Minnesota Sports Facilities Authority to ban the use of the name the Washington Redskins football team on November 7th. Now, that's going to be when the Vikings take on the Washington football team at the Metrodome. They say they want all references to the Washington team's mascot and name to not be used because it's very offensive for their children to hear.
They start hearing the chant and see the rubber tomahawks and painted faces and chicken feathers, and they start screaming and scalp them effing Vikings or massacre those twins and all this kind of stuff. These kids get children, they get scared. It has a tremendous psychological effect on them. Grandpa, Grandpa, let's go home. Let's go home.
But the attorney for the Sports Facilities Authority say they cannot put legal parameters around what can and cannot be said inside the Metrodome. He said the role of the authority is to provide public accommodations, not put prior restraints on free speech. The authority, though, will set up a PA system for the American Indian movement to hold a protest outside of the dome on game day. Now, the Vikings team said they also will not be preventing the use of the team name on the scoreboards or on the announcements.
We're one of 32 teams, and we have an obligation to carry on the marketing of the game, regardless of the team. And again, deferring to the NFL in terms of direction on this, but until they tell us that something has changed, we'll proceed as usual.
Also, at today's meeting, we learned Mortenson Construction will have to come out with a guaranteed maximum sale price by next week. That will be the final cost of the stadium if the Sports Facilities Authority agrees with it. Now, the preliminary estimate for the construction costs sits at $737 million. Reporting live in Minneapolis, Kate Renner, 5 Eyewitness News.
Kate, thanks. And here's some good news.